that, I think. But this, Joel, that Mike Milbury, things got a little rough, but somehow, and I did not see it. I don't know if you did, Chico. It was removed from where the puck was. Lemaire and Milbury became involved.
Well, usually the goalie holds on to the puck to give his defenseman for his forward's arrest, but in that instance, Kenny is the one who needed the rest. Here we see it. He's way out at the blue line to make a good poke check. And then you see the puck will come to him, and people may wonder, well, why didn't he tie it up? If he would have caused a whistle there, it would have been a penalty. So he had to let it go. And here you see him just streaking back, and Gila points in the net. And like I say, I've never seen anything like that. That was wild.
Coming in, Gainey is trying to get in front. And Park was there. Oh! Park was felt behind the net by Gainey. Down on the left side. Jarvis going down, and he's called on the offside. Jarvis and Rick Smith, they come to blows. And, oh, Robinson went in there quickly. Gainey has a stranglehold on Mark Cott. But I don't think a punch was thrown.
No, Larry Robinson maybe tried to give a little love tap there to just say back off a little bit to Rick Smith, but nothing much materialized, I think.
Anything to cause you to change your style. We just have to go out and play our game and win our games at home. That's what we've worked all year for.
Well, as you heard the voice of Larry Robinson very calmly talking about the Canadian strategy, when we looked at the live action, he was rather excitedly directing some comments to Rick Smith of the Bruins. For the Canadians, to the left side for Gainey, and he collides with Ghost. Two rocket into the Ghost.
Well, it's interesting. Here you'll see the top of your screen there, Lafleur and Marcotte, who, like you say, are mild-mannered. And then Jacques Lemaire gets involved. I think it's just a case of frustration on both parts. Lafleur, who's been shadowed by Marcotte most of the series, must feel a little frustrated. Marcotte, who, although he's doing a good job, things aren't going well for his team tonight. He's a little frustrated, and that's what this sort of thing leads to.
Penalty coming up. There's the shot. Keever stopping it. He got a stick out against Rysbaugh. Rysbaugh of O'Reilly started to exchange punches. And Stickle gets in there quickly. A lot of milling about. We see dancing around Trombley and Spott. And Lombaire has Brad Park as his partner. So the dancing is stopped and the penalty will be assessed. The goaltender was in on that one, Chico, one way or another, when it all began. But Rysbrow wasn't seeing action all that much here tonight. Cut away from Cheevers. Now we get Schmatz and Mario Tremblay looking as though they want to, and now they are going to go. Tremblay in the white sweater, Bobby Schmatz in the dark. Are they ever going to throw a punch? Around because they're trying to convoy O'Reilly and Rysbrow to the penalty box. Newell hasn't stepped in the middle, and there has been a punch thrown.
I imagine each is hoping the official will go.
Oh, what a way down by Tremblay! Scored with a tremendous right hand. Well, that was the punch. He gets the same reaction from the Montreal crowd that Stan Zanavan got from the Boston crowd the other night in his fight with Pierre Bouchard. All through that session, they were doing it to the accompaniment of the theme from Star Wars. It's being pumped out over the organ by the forum organist.
I don't know if it's been bad blood between the Bruins and the Canadians, but there's been a fair amount of blood anyway.
Well, that's true.
Ray Dan Ull. Ull over the line. Jarvis in there. And O'Reilly gave Ray Dan Ull a solid jolt. Gainey and Milbury started to do some fencing. Now Cheevers is coming out to get a close-up look. He's going to send them off, too. And that was rather interesting. Cournoyer tried to knock it down, then Cournoyer upended his man Milbury. Here's Savard making a move on the right side. Over it goes, and just they score!
into the corner, dashing in there is LeFleur. Let's see, a slashing penalty. Oh, shot was belted by Jonathan. He was given a jarring jolt by Jonathan, and Shutt is going to the penalty box. And the puck finally onto the stick, a bad cut. Cashman was upended by Gainey, and the Bruins supporters did some hollering on that. Gainey upending Cashman.
Now Cashman's going to get a penalty. He went by Gainey and gave him a flip, and look at Brad Park. He is going after Newell, something fierce.
Actually, Dick, what happened there, he went by Newell with a stick up high, and as he did, I think he said something to him, and I think it's just going to be an unsportsmanlike penalty.
Oh, I see. I thought it was Gainey that he clipped. Well, we'll see. Park is very upset.
They had a whole period to play, and they can't afford to take these penalties at this stage of the game.
Boston penalty number 12, Wayne Cashman, 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct. At 15 minutes, 2 seconds.
Good call, Chico. I can hear and read the post-game quotes already from the Boston side of things. Oh, yes, Newell has been under tremendous fire. Verbal fire from the Bruins. On this one, Cherry hasn't reacted at all. Just standing without making a move or saying anything in back of the Boston bench. He's let Cashman first to...
There are times everyone would like to say something, but sometimes you have to hold back. And here you'll see Dave Newell in the corner. Now, you're going to see Wayne Cashman come with a stick up. Ooh, just a close shave there, buddy. And he must have said something to him at the same time. I didn't realize he came so close. You see Dave Newell actually jump back, so... There wasn't much he could do, I guess. I think I would have called the same thing.
And you see Park go into his tirade against Newell, which continued for quite a while.
Going on. Now Jarvis and Milbury. Jarvis is a bit truculent. He ordinarily does not get into any kind of skirmishes. But he's playing a fine driving game for the Canadians tonight, number 21, Jarvis. He's into it.
But it was Milbury and Jarvis who had their sticks up. Here's a replay here. We'll see the puck go out front. Oh, Jerry Kievers gives a little cuff on the side of the head to Jarvis, and Jarvis, again, unexpectedly, gave him an elbow back, and Jerry's pointing like, did you see that?
McNabb, a big fellow who drew only... two minor penalties throughout 80 games of the regular season, has now gone to the penalty box. So everything is happening. Dougie Jarvis, who doesn't get many penalties, had a couple for Montreal. Now you see O'Reilly being restrained by John Wensing as he directs remarks in the area of Newell. And there is the most beleaguered man in the building in this fifth game of the Stanley Cup Finals. So we'll sort this one out. The original call was against McNabb.
And to number 24, Terry O'Reilly, a game misconduct penalty at 27 seconds.
Well, there is O'Reilly, who is talking things over with Coach Cherry. There's not much he can do by remaining on the ice. He is gone. And there he goes, shaking his head rather sadly. Well, this is turning into a long, drawn-out, penalty-filled affair. There's Jerry Cheevers.
They're going after, going right in on goal, LeFleur. He fired it. Locked on the short side. LeFleur upended by Miller. Miller is going to get a penalty, number 14 for Hockey.
And we've got an injured Bruin back in front of the net, Dennis O'Brien.
By Ronnie Graham, coming in cold.
Watch O'Brien in front of the net. Oh, he was clipped by Graham's stick. With 5 minutes left in the third period, Mike Milbury makes his fourth trip to the penalty box as he lays a two-hander on Ivan Cornoyer.
Here you'll see this thing with, an elbow, and LeFleur give one back, and that's what caused that little rhubarb earlier.
To the corner, LaRouche. He scored a big goal for the Canadians, their third goal. He's into the corner area along with Miller. Risebrough jammed by Jonathan. Could have something here. Robinson has a hold of Milbury. Now Wincik is pounding. Is that Tremblay?
Yes, it is.
quarters are very close. I don't know how telling his right hand were to the side of Trombley's head.
No, as we remember, this set up with Robinson. There they go at it again.
This may be a dress rehearsal for the sixth game. If they keep this up, it'll be undress rehearsal. Pulling the sweater.
There's LaPointe and Miller now going after each other. Oh. And this has turned into a real grudge series. It really has. The thing the other night, and they're really wailing away. And there's
LaPointe got Miller with a vicious right, knocked him to the ice. But before that, Miller scored near the undressed part of it coming. LaPointe's jersey is being pulled over his head. Miller has LaPointe against the board, and LaPointe now is just separated from his jersey.
In a situation like this, Danny, there's too bad there's not a couple officials dressed that can just go out in the ice and give those guys a hand.
There's Trombley. He got a right hand free, and he hit Winsick. Now Winsick with his left hand, two of them, and the right hand by Trombley. They bounce each other into the board. Milbury still has Robinson pinned in there. And out in front of the net, we have Jonathan and Risebrow.
And well, we know Wensick's unlikely to give up. If you remember the other night, Wensick and Lupien went at it almost till everything, you know, for about 2 minutes, till finally the referees had everything else restored. Then they were able to separate them. But Wensick just doesn't seem to know when to quit. And Trombley at the same time, he's still throwing them. And now Dave Newell finally gets them separated. And hopefully they're both so tired, this will all end and we'll play out the last 21 seconds.
Well, the ice is littered as usual with gloves and sticks. And the biggest problem is to sort the sticks and gloves out and give them to the proper recipient. That came with 21 seconds left. So it's the battle of 21, period three. Trombley, he'll go to the dressing room. So the score, incidentally, it's still a hockey game with 21 seconds left. 4-1, Montreal leading Boston.
Sure sets up that next game, doesn't it, though, Dan? You just don't know what to expect now. It's been rather a quiet series. Of course, we had the big fight in the first period the other night in Boston, but other than that, the first three games were rather quiet. There's Trombley making his way into the dressing room. Very slowly, I might add. He's not quite ready. He's waiting for the hand, which he's now finally receiving, and takes his bow, and now he's...
There's a fellow who knows something about battling. Lupien.
Oh, the gesture there is, remember when Lupien and Wensick went at it the other night? After the fight, Wensick stood up and gave him the old "I'm the winner" sign, and now Lupien is... to give him the raspberries there.
So Wensing is standing at the gate leading.